Today I'm going to head to Dartmouth, Nova Scotia to go to One Fish, Two Fish and do some fish supplies and scaping supplies shopping. I've turned on a couple of the tanks that I need stuff for. First and foremost, what's up, Walroot? They're always so always out greeting me. I might get some fish for this tank, but I do have a bit of a plan and things that I want to restrict myself to. If I can find enough tetras for this tank, I'll grab some. I do need a substrate for this. I'm going to get some crushed coral or sand for this. Maybe. I might also do bare bottom because this tank is going to be an anemone aquarium. We're going to do a bunch of anemones and a harem of clowns, maybe 20 clownfish in there. Don't need anything for this tank right now. It's such a mess out here, so ignore that. I need complete stocking for this. Not sure exactly what we'll end up doing. And then, of course, the cylinder tank. I have some ideas. Let's go see if I could do it.
All right, made it. We will probably just do a little looking around. This will end up probably just being a tour. And then I gotta focus and get some fish in a bag.
Lots of tissue culture plants. I already see some that I need. I'll probably get some more dwarf hair grass for the planted tank. What else we got here? I wouldn't mind finding some different colors, but let's see what we can come up with. Alright, let's go check other stuff out. It's a hardscaping. One of the things I was going to do with the cylinder tank, I was going to do Texas Holy Rock, but they just didn't have enough here. Lots of other cool stuff, though. I love this rock here, that blue cereal. Look at it. Tons of character coloration to it. One thing I want to show you guys here. Oh, yeah. The rays are both out. What's up, bro?
Just
straight up. The pearls?
Yeah.
Told you they look better in here. You like them?
I love them.
Yeah. That's the boy and the girl. They're a hardy. Hardy ray. They won't bother this one. I was going to slip in the back room and see if what you're... Do you got any anemones back there?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to take it.
Yeah, that rock's whole
bubble. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think we might start off with this bad boy. What do you guys think? We'll see. We will see. Yep. What else we got in there? I like this too. But definitely. See, I'm late. They had so many of these anemones just crowding. And I was like, oh, I'm going to get them all. But no, I'll just get that one, I think, to start. See how it does. Do I need to make any adjustments to my tank or something? Okay, so there are some fish over here. Oh, no. They only have a few female bettas. I was thinking about doing that for the cylinder tank, but they only have 1, 2, 3, 4. I think they only have like 4 or 5 in there. Another option for the planted tank. I'm definitely going to get some Siamese algae eaters. Oh, and I think I might get some threadfin rainbows. I seen these guys here the other day. Gorgeous little guys. They're only babies. They all get bigger, but that would be absolutely fantastic in that tank, wouldn't it? Lots of really good ratio of males to females as well. They got some black neons. I wonder if they got any cardinals. Maybe I'll just look at each tank. Oh, they got some sterbite.
Corydora. These are zebra danios. Jeez, maybe we do that. It's been years since I kept zebra danios. Maybe I just clear out the whole tank of zebra danios, because these are incredibly active fish and they would look absolutely stunning in the cylinder tank. So keep in mind, we need the planted tank fish.
So planted tank, we might do these and these. Ooh, they got some panda corydora as well. Maybe all of them guys. Those guys are nice, aren't they? Oh man, what else we got here? Every time I see these clownfish, oh, look at that ribbon eel. Is that a ribbon? Yeah, it is a ribbon eel. He'd be cool. Every time I see a bunch of clownfish, though, definitely what I want. Venezuelan guppies.
Oh, wait a minute. Looks like they're all males. No? Yeah. Those would be kind of cool in the cylinder tank.
Even thought about platies. We'll go down there in a minute. And they got all kinds of fish here. I timed my visit to get here when they actually have some fish. Oh, you like the guppies?
We gotta go with these guys because they only have 5 female bettas. What, for this, for the cylinder tank?
Yes.
Well, the females are beautiful, to be honest with you, as well as the males. Maybe. Oh, look at that red one. You like them?
Yeah. Look, there's so many pretty tails.
Yeah, these guys are actually pretty gorgeous. Look at you. Oh, look at your friend.
Yeah, I like these. The guppies are weird because the male is the cute one and the female is the ugly one.
I don't know. I think they're
sounds familiar.
No. Look at the cool fish. You chonk.
What are you doing in here?
Ooh, these guys are pretty too. Cobalt gourami. Oh, wow. These guys are really nice. Yeah. Aren't they though? What do you think of these? Well, I think they're based off, yeah, it is a dwarf gourami, but I was thinking it was based off the dwarf gourami and then just line bred to look like this, but these guys are, like, glowing. How much are they? $8? Remember, these are Canadian prices as well, guys, so most of you guys are in the States, so chop off about 30% of that price, and then there, it'll be more comparison. You got some neons, but we have cardinals, so I feel like once you have cardinals, the neons are, like, a step down, so I don't think I'll get them. Oh, I'm pretty sure I want to get these for the cylinder tank. People will kill me, but man, we need some guppies. We need something simple. I wanted to do the Betta sorority tank, but I've also been thinking platies and... Oh, they got a silver arowana. What?
Those mollies are pretty.
Yeah. Guess how big this guy's going to get?
They had the potential to get to 4 feet long.
4 feet?
Yeah.
What?
Absolutely massive. And odds are he's gonna get drop eye. They get so big. I've had a couple of these before. If you want an arowana, you gotta get a black because they don't get the drop eye. These are silvers. They will eventually get drop eye unless they're wild caught, and then it's 50-50. But those are most likely tank raised, especially at that price. Believe it or not, the wilds are typically less effective. Yeah, these guys are like great in streams and rivers. So I believe they're like a pleco of some sort with modified, they're loaches actually, with modified pectoral fins, like their side fins, to allow them to grasp onto sides in fast flowing rivers. Look, they got some bronze. Oh no, those are called blue corridor. Let's see what else.
They already got a bunch of fish that I want. I gotta figure this out.
Oh, aren't you pretty? Lipstick tang. That's the thought of salt water. Why you gotta put lipstick on, bro? Lots of salt. There's lots of puffers, the dog face puffer. Let's see what else we got here.
What else left?
What else they got for plants? Oh, let me see. Any more anemones in here? You guys see any? I'm gonna get all the anemones. I'm gonna be an enemy, man. I got so many enemies, I need more anemones. Oh god, I'm not a rapper.
Maybe I should be.
I really like these too. Ludwigia. These are actually really nice. Maybe I grab them all as a background plant for the new planta tank. We'll see. Alright, just cut this guy out the corner of my eye. Oh my. Oh. I need you. Do you need me? You can come. No, I gotta stick to the story, the plan, the anemone tank. If I do an anemone tank, you're not gonna be okay in there. But you're so pretty. I need you to be a part of my family. Oh, I should have got him instead of Kevin. But I like Kevin. I'm not mad. I'm okay.
He's cute.
Yeah, he is cute. Wow. That's a bicolor angel. Very nice.
Look how tiny that fox face is.
He's a little baby.
That's small.
What you doing over there, bro? Come on out so we can see you guys. Don't you wanna... You'd think that fish at the store would be like, feel like they're orphans and they gotta show off to everybody so they can come home. But luckily I know how to move this. Where you going, bro? Ooh, he's nice. It's a regal angel.
Very pretty. Very colorful.
Alright, I need to make a decision here. Oh, another bicolor angel.
Okay, now that we have got an idea of what's here, let's figure out what we want to get for each tank. Let's start with the cylinder tank, I believe.
Oh, geez. I either want to go with the leopard danios,
and I mean
all of them, or see what else here. Can you see anything up there?
Yeah.
Okay. Or, man, I'm really attracted to these guys. Not in the wrong way. Maybe. I don't. I hope you guys don't judge me. But I was also thinking guppies. Many of you guys want me to keep guppies. Something more relatable and stuff. And I think these guys, this beautiful splash of color in that dark tank that look...
could look absolutely phenomenal. By the way, I made that shirt. Link is in the description below. You guys were saying, you gotta make the absolutely phenomenal t-shirt. So I did. It's down there. And those guys would look absolutely phenomenal in the cylinder tank.
Bristlenose plecos. Platties.
Okay.
So, let me see how this sounds. We go guppies in the cylinder tank. And we'll get like, it's 100 gallons, 25 gallons, 120 gallons. The sump with the sump. I mean, we're looking at probably get at least 40 of these guys. You know, 3 gallons a piece. That should be good. Especially with the amount of filtration I have. Oh, we never looked over here. Wait. Okay, so we're gonna get into cichlids over here, it looks like. What we got here? It's a blue dolphin, so that's a Lake Malawi fish. There's a frontosa in there. One reason. Doesn't look like they got any orders of... There's some dwarf.
Or at least some rams. Which is a
dwarf cichlid, in my opinion. They get tiny. Pink convicts. No, I've got enough cichlids. We've done enough cichlids. Oh, what's wrong, bro?
The puffers they got here are crazy. What's wrong? You don't look good. Oh, he's healthy. He's just
moping. A lot of puffers do that. What? Yeah. Oh, he is nice.
It's really cool.
Have you seen this guy over here?
What? Oh my gosh! He's a giant version of him.
He's what?
He's a giant version of him.
Yeah. He's a chonk.
He's got his arms out like he's Naruto. Okay, that's it. You guys got a sneak peek at some things that I'm looking at. We did a little bit of a tour of this store, but things are getting weird. I gotta shut this camera off and actually buy some stuff. We'll see you guys in the next one.